One, two, three, four.
If you've got a little time and you wanna waste some more, take a trip round the corner to the house of four doors. One takes you somewhere.
I'm walking up to Mookie's place. I just woke up and I'm gonna surprise him and see if we can't get some stuff shot today. I don't know what it's gonna be, but I guess we'll find out soon.
Who is it?
Hey, it's me. I'm here.
What?
I just woke up. Want to do some shooting?
Yeah, come on. Give me a minute. I gotta, I just gotta, have a few drinks and then just, I'll be out in a minute.
All right, so I'll just wait out here for a while.
Yeah, no, that's cool, man.
All right.
All right, it's a beautiful morning on my day off. And you see the subject lying in the Jesus Christ pose, surrounded by his disciples, which are beer cans. And he's awake. I'm sure I should wake him up, so I'm just gonna give him a kick here. Hey, you gotta get up. They need you, I guess. I mean, you can keep sleeping, but it's not very conducive to the documentary we're trying to shoot here. So. Hey. It's you. You alright there, buddy? You had a few grown-up soda pops last night, huh?
Oh, fuck. Somebody at the door.
What's that?
Is there somebody at the door?
I have no idea, actually. Start right off the bat, huh? About 10 in the morning.
10?
Yeah,
at
I just...
night?
No, AM, not PM.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah, I just got off work. Did a double shift yesterday. I had to come in 2 hours later. I don't really get any sleep.
I better go down and see Phil. What he's up to.
Yeah, I saw him down in the car. I didn't really get a good look at him, but he's down there. I haven't seen Ozzie yet.
Wow, let's go down and get him. It's time for breakfast. What are you doing out here, Oz?
He told me to wait on you.
Huh? When?
Just when I got here before.
Oh, yeah. I got up. I was totally hungover. And,
I didn't know Oz was waiting outside. I mean, I did. I guess I remember sort of, you know, him at the door. But I went upstairs, had a few drinks, and passed out, you know. Vint came upstairs, and he's, you know, yelling at me, I got to get down there. So I'm like, whatever, and I get down there. And Oz was bitching at me. He said I, you know, had him waiting down there for 2 hours. And I felt really bad about it, you know, but, you know, I forgot about it. Bottom line is, you know, I'm sorry, but, you know, shit happens. Phil. Phil. Bud. Hey.
What?
You got a dead fly on your face.
Where?
You know, maybe if you didn't have so much garbage in your car, you wouldn't attract flies.
You know why flies are attracted to me? Because they know I'm full of shit.
Come on, man. Get
that's,
up.
That's pretty funny, Phil.
We got to get something to eat. I'm hungry. Well, can I have a beer, please? I need something for breakfast.
Here.
That's the breakfast of champions.
Saltines
beer.
Right here. That's like toast, kind of. Oh.
Beer and crackers, yeah, that's like, you can't get a whiter breakfast than that, I'm telling you what, man.
Huh?
Oh. It's very dry, like, I could use some beer with it.
That's like white, very white bread right there, man. Crackers and beer. That's like,
I gave you a couple beers last night, did you drink them?
Yeah, I think I did.
Oh. Yeah, he was pretty drunk when he passed out in the car. I actually, the battery ran out, otherwise I would have got it. I mean, I got him going to sleep, but... He woke back up and had some more beer before he actually fell asleep.
I thought we had some vodka.
Oh no, I left it at home.
Close that door there, camera guy.
Can you unleave it at home? Can you go get it?
I'm a little thirsty. Well, I'd like to eat some breakfast first. I mean,
here we go.
If you've got anything, I mean.
Here's some dumpster bologna. I got some last night.
Oh, thanks.
You don't remember that? Yeah.
Maybe if you had some eggs or something, I would, you know.
I'm working on
bologna
it.
And eggs, yeah.
That
sounds good to me.
I'm working on it.
What do you mean you're working on it?
Oh, Jesus.
I'm working on quite an appetite here, so.
Dumpster bananas.
You must have fucking drank a ton last night, dude. You look like shit.
Yeah, look how much alcohol he sweated out onto his hair there. What's left of his hair anyway?
You know, it gets sweaty. The sun comes up, it's just unbearable sometimes. Oh.
Is that dumpster sardines there on the dash?
No, I actually bought those.
Oh, how much were they?
I
was going to say, it's perfect.
I think they were 50 cents
or something.
Yeah, actually, that's a pretty cheap source of protein, actually.
Where'd you get that banana?
Out of a dumpster.
Smells well, pretty good.
Some. I want a bite.
Alright.
Yeah, here. Sure, yeah, thank you. You got some, camera guy?
Fuck you, camera
asshole. Just pretend I'm not here, okay? Please.
And that's not really how we're doing it.
You can get upset about it. Please. I mean, I know we don't have any alcohol in here, but...
Don't worry, you're not on camera.
I know that, but emotionally I'm on camera. That's enough.
Let's get some eggs going, brother.
Put an egg in there last night. Should be about
done. Holy shit.
Huh. I wouldn't think that part gets hot enough.
Alright, let me try it.
Best way to have it.
That tastes like gasoline, man.
Well, there's drawbacks.
Fuck.
Thanks for the breakfast there, I guess.
What?
Yeah.
So, Barrel Ball, a.k.a. Super Checkdown City, that's a game that Phil made up. We play it, you know, sometimes when it's nice out or whatever, and, you know, we're bored or we're really drunk. It's an okay game. I mean, you know, he expects it to become, like, a really big sensation, like the next American pastime or whatever, but, you know, I doubt that's going to happen. All right, so here are the rules of the game. You guys listening?
I'm listening.
All right, the rules are you put a barrel about 15 yards.
Okay.
55-gallon barrel. You put it about 15 yards away. Everybody, you have to use an NFL-sized football, professional-sized. Everybody gets four throws. That's your turn. You get four throws. Basically, what you do is it's like horseshoes in that respect. You just try to make it in as few shots as possible. Then the next person has to match you if you make it. Say you make it on your first throw, the other person's got to make it on their first throw.
So it's like horse.
Yeah, and you get a point. You get a point for every, you know, every time that happens. The first person to four that gets 4 points wins one game. If you're gonna do a series, the first person to four games wins, basically. So it can take a while.
Okay, I think I understand that.
And then if the ball.
Why do you get four throws?
Well, you start out with four downs, like
it's like simulating like in the NFL when you get four downs. I think that's
You get four downs.
That makes sense.
But you know, like I said, if you throw it, say you make it in your third throw, we got to make it by then. But if we make it, say I step up, I make it first throw, then everybody's got to match that instead.
It's like horse. Okay, it's like a mix of horse and like, you know.
And you get a point.
Football or something.
If you're the one that makes it, your shot, and now nobody else makes theirs, you get a point.
Okay, all right, yeah, I got it.
And then there's also another wrinkle, too. There's defense. You can stand by the barrel. What you do is if I were to throw it and it bounces off the barrel and goes up in the air, if you were to catch it before it hits the ground, it's your possession.
Okay.
So it's like an interception.
Yeah. Okay, yeah, that makes sense.
Sounds good. Let's
play. Can you block it from going in?
No. Nope. Oh. You can't touch the ball until it's actually already crossed the plane of the barrel.
So it has to touch the barrel or pass it?
It has to pass the barrel to touch it.
So if as long as it's either touched the barrel or passed it, then you can
touch it, yeah.
Okay. What if it bounces up in the air and you catch it?
That's an interception. So then you get the ball.
So then it's your turn. So then it would be my turn if I did that.
Yes.
Okay.
So say you make your.
What happens to the person throwing it if they throw the interception?
They can't match.
Are they eliminated from the game or just from?
Nope,
that?
Just from that point.
Okay.
So say I made it or you made it in your third throw.
Okay.
And then I'm up to try to match you. I throw it. It hits the barrel on the first throw and pops up in the air and intercepts it. Obviously, I can't. I can't match the point.
The old turd throw special, basically.
Yeah. On your turd throw.
Yeah, all right, on the turd throw, like if you're Irish, you know, which I am.
Yeah, let's get started.
So, yeah, I'll start out.
I'm starting to get shaky.
I'll go first.
Not having any beer.
All right.
Oh.
All right, second down. Proper defense here.
Oh. Oh. A little high. If you kick it in, you get, you can only kick it on fourth down. But if you were to actually kick it in, then you get an automatic point. That counts.
It went out.
That counts. If it hits the bottom of the barrel and pops out, it counts.
I don't know. That sounds like you just made that up on the fly.
No, that counts.
All right, you got it. It went in and it jumped right out.
Doesn't really matter.
Don Marnold throws.
Oh.
On the curb throw. Oh.
Yes.
Oh, my God.
On second.
So that's a point for me.
What?
In one shot. Bastard. One shot, boys. So tied 1-1, me and Oz.
Yep.
Phil just sucks at it. He invented the game, but he sucks at it.
Honestly, it's really a waste of our time. I mean, it's the time we spend doing that, we could be getting cans or going through dumpsters or whatever. And we're not really doing anything with it. We're just wasting our time. I mean, it's fun and all that shit, but I mean, especially when you're really drunk, you know, you don't really know what's going on. You don't really care. I mean, I guess it's all right, but there's a lot better things we could be doing with our time. You know, I'll tell you that.
basically, I had this idea, you know, that's been churning around in my mind for some time. You know, take it upon myself to teach everyone else, you know, everybody, about freeganism. It's a concept I've recently embraced over the past few years, and it's done a lot of great things in my life, personally, you know. And, you know, I kind of want to give that to other people and just show them that, you know, things that would otherwise go to waste, you know, you can sustain yourself on it. You know, the whole concept of freeganism and sustainability really plays in, you know, to my lifestyle. So why not share that with other people? You know, I figured I'd start a group. You know, I went to the library and used their computers to print up flyers and things. And I set up a meeting, a weekly meeting. You know, a few people came, you know, it hasn't been as many people as I thought, but, you know, we've had a few good meetings. But at the first meeting, I met a guy, Ozzie, and Mookie, too, that they've been kind of the people that have been hanging out the most, you know, at the meetings and stuff. But Ozzie was actually doing a documentary already, so he decided to just kind of flip what he was doing there and to just concentrate on the whole freeganism thing. And that's basically where we're at now. I think freeganism is very important for today. I mean, if you want to, you know, mitigate the economy being the way it is, you know, it's tough. You know, people need, and this today's economy, whatever break they can get, you know, is good. Otherwise, you know, they just have to work and try to survive in the hamster wheel. You know, people are going to have to live more sustainably. That's bottom line, and that's what I'm here to try and help people with.
Hey, Phil, what's up, dude?
Hey, we gotta get some recycles going here. Let's go. All
right. There you go. There you go. I got a lot of fucking shit in here, Phil, more than usual.
Buckle your safety belt.
Scrunching room only, dude. Scrunching room only.
Oh my god, this is insane, man.
Hey.
Let's go.
This is the business we've chosen.
He can't even shift the car, man.
Here we go. There we go, now we're going.
You know what, Phil?
You know what?
Turn here.
This is ridiculous, man.
So yeah, I gotta take a left.
I know where
they're
going.
All right, still got a chip here. Well, I'm just so fucking with all the shit in the car, man. Tired.
What are you doing?
Sensible.
What are you doing?
They ain't even moving here.
Good lord.
Phil, it's too much sometimes.
Asshole! There's your cans, huh? Want your cans? There you go.
Nine times out of ten, I find something good in this dumpster.
Well, I'll tell you, that, you know, if you just keep doing what you're doing.
What? Oh, you got some Kahlua.
You just keep doing what you're doing, you know, and I'll manage somehow. I didn't have a very good day, honestly.
You seem like you're a little drunk there, buddy.
I was playing Texas Hold'em.
How'd you do?
I didn't do well, Phil. Okay, that's fair. What I'm trying to say to you.
I'm not trying to.
So I hope this freaking dumpster dive shit really works out, because otherwise I'm fucked, dude, because the first of the month's coming and I got my rent due. I don't have any money. I freaking spent all of it on the poker game.
That's not good.
I have problems, Phil, and I need something.
There we go. There's the mother load right here.
I don't know if I want to do this, Phil. This is kind of greasy, man.
It can be greasy, but let's see what we're going to get. You're hungry, right?
Greasy and slimy and wet and sticky.
Well,
and
usually this one's not that bad. I mean, you'll see.
All right. Here, take the camera. Would you move?
Hold it for a sec. He's got to get out.
I got to get out of here. What do you got in here? Let's see.
What's in here, Phil?
It smells pretty bad. I don't think this has been changed in a long time.
Let me get right in here and see if I can see anything. Let's rip it apart. Yeah, we get out of here. Fuck. Shit. Fuck is in here.
Hey, we got some recycles.
Oh, Jesus, Phil. This stinks, man. It's all rotten chicken and shit.
Look at that. Go through that.
Oh, fuck. Hey, Phil, there's fucking beer in here, man.
What?
Yeah.
No way.
It's unopened beer.
Holy shit. I told you guys. I told you. You never know what you're going to find, dude. Hey, careful. Let's take it easy.
Whoa. Haven't you had enough already, Mookie?
Phil. Free beer. Holy shit.
Here, have a beer.
Oh, I will.
I would wait or tap it or something.
Yeah, just pack it back up, man. We got more to go through.
Jesus.
Holy shit. Man of recycling, dude. Look at that.
What's in there?
It's all beer recycled.
Who the hell threw the recyclables in the garbage?
Look at that.
Look at this. Another
That's
bag.
Like $1.50 right there.
This is like fucking Christmas, dude. Holy shit.
What else is...
There's a being John Malkovich, Russian doll.
Look, a back scratcher, you know?
Hey, there's some flatbread.
Flatbread?
A little rotted, but...
This is a mother load right here.
There's a movie in here, too. DVDs. Creepshow.
Creepshow.
A guitar pedal. Holy shit. Oh, well, former guitar pedal. It was probably already broken.
Cut these. Jaggy glass in there.
Look at this. Ninja Turtles. The game. Hook that up tonight.
Oh, dude.
Got chips?
There's chips and bologna in here?
Who the hell throws this away?
Oh, this is still good, dude.
It's a pound of bologna, perfectly good.
It tastes great.
I don't know who throws this shit away here.
Starving.
Here, have some. I'll keep going through this stuff.
I'm starving.
Save a little bit of that for us for later, though.
I'm not mad at bologna. I mean, I love bologna. Two slices of white bread and a slice of bologna. That's what I grew up on, man. My parents, they never knew how to cook. They didn't give a shit. So, they used to slap a couple slices of bread with a piece of bologna, and that was my lunch every day, growing up. I love bologna sandwiches. Who doesn't, especially when you're drinking.
Take all this out of here.
Once you get that cheap liquor in you pound it down, you can make a bologna sandwich taste like a ribeye steak.
Hey, man, that was a good haul.
That's what I'm saying. We got a bag
couple
of recycles.
Beers in there.
We got like $2 or $3 in recycles.
Oz, you want a beer, man? There's beer in there.
They better not.
Crack it right open.
I'm allergic, man.
You're allergic to beer.
Yeah, kind
of. There's a couple of cigarette ashes on
it. I didn't used to be, but I got an allergy.
There's some dirt on there, but it's good. It's not open.
Why would it have been in a dumpster? Perfectly good beer like that. Oh,
who knows?
Phil, fucking thing's foaming up on me.
I told you to tap on it.
Fucking whore.
Oh, that's good.
Hold on, don't move.
Hey, have you guys boys been doing a little drinking? Have you?
Second back on Grandpa's cough medicine.
I got her.
You got it?
I got her somewhat. You want a little drinky poop, bud? It's good for you. Yeah. Cheers, brother.
Beer in the fucking dumpster.
Woo!
Here we go.
Whoa. Jesus.
Mookie,
what the hell?
You all right there, Mook?
I dropped my hat. Where's help me find my hat, man?
I smell shit. I mean, it doesn't smell that bad in there.
Fuck, it stinks in this fucking thing. Fuck.
There it is.
Fuck.
Oh, shit.
Oh, fuck, oh. Yeah, it's a good ball.
It's all cracked up.
I remember when I was, you know.
How did that happen?
That's probably why they threw it away.
Sorry, Mookie. Here, let me help you out. That's
get me the fuck out of here, boys. Jesus Christ.
There
fuck.
You go.
Jesus, help me. Jesus. Fuck. Oh, God.
You alright?
Well, the perils are of dumpster diving have been well chronicled. Look at it.
Oh, jeez, look at that.
Yeah, we can't sell it.
Throw that back in there, man. That's no good.
It's a bunch of garbage. Fuck.
Whore.
Garbage. Well, that was just...
Close the top, Mook.
I mean, there was napkins and stuff.
Ah.
Don't poo.
Boys, I lost the flashlight.
Close the top there, Mook.
The flashlight?
I lost it.
I didn't know you had a flashlight there.
When'd you have it last?
I had a flashlight somewhere.
Yeah.
I lost
the
it.
Thing didn't work too good anyway. Not like we're missing.
All right, let's
that's
head back.
35-cent flashlight, man.
Well, that's what? That's 7 cans.
Yeah.
You're right, I guess.
The first time we went out dumpster diving, it pretty much sucked. I mean, to be honest with you, diving in dumpsters for garbage sucks anyway. I mean, it's no fun. Nobody wants to do it. But when we went out the first time, you know, couldn't find anything. I mean, it's basically all dead. There's, you know, nothing in the fucking garbage cans. And, you know, I didn't have much confidence in Phil at that point. I mean, I didn't think he knows what he's doing. I mean, I still don't think he knows what he's doing. I think he's a fucking idiot, basically. But, you know, we had almost no success at all. And the second time we went out, you know, we did end up finding some stuff. I mean, we found some bologna in the dumpster, and I found some beers, which was awesome. You know, I mean, I was really happy about that. So, you know, I kind of felt like I could do this, you know. It might be able to work for me. I mean, but dumpster diving is just really degrading. It sucks, basically. I mean, get all dirty and smelly, and, you know, you could get freaking, like, animals in there, rats and raccoons biting at you. And it's an awful thing. But, I mean, you gotta do what you gotta do, you know, to try and survive and, you know, support any kind of addiction that you might have.
If you're feeling so